Good morning, my friends. Welcome back to Dana Two Ponies. And here's what I kind of consider a true, what some people call a devotional. Just bear with me. To me, it's just, you know, I believe we're called to actually study what Scripture says and not what somebody else says. So let's just real quick, this won't take long. Now, accept the, this is Romans 14, 1 through 4. Now, accept the one who is weak in faith, but not for the purpose of passing judgment on his opinions. One person has faith that he may eat all things, but he who is weak eats vegetables only. The one who eats is not to regard with contempt the one who does not eat. And the one who does not eat is not to judge the one who eats, for God has accepted him. Who are you to judge the servant of another? To his own master he stands or falls, and he will stand, for the Lord is able to make him stand. So, you know, as someone who's really into, you know, I really have done a deep dive lately, going beyond the Atkins induction level of, you know, a way of eating, and gone into carnivore for my own reasons. So someone on my side of the fence of that argument might look at that, say, but he who is weak eats vegetables only. And that can really be taken out of context. This is not about our diets. I mean, I do believe the Bible when it says fat satiates, which means it satisfies. And maybe there's an inflection here that eating vegetables only may not give you everything you need. I don't know. But I think the whole point here is, you know, this isn't about arguing over what we eat. You know, as far as what is healthy, what is weight loss, and in the terms we're using a lot of food discussions today. This is about Old Covenant and New Covenant. This is about God. It's, you know, and it's about understanding what He wills for our hearts. And this is totally what I believe. We are not to take this and use, you know, things like this against someone else. You know, in the Old Covenant, the Jews were still under the law, there were food restrictions, and there were very specific ways God wanted them to worship Him. And there are still ways God shows us He wants us to worship Him now. They have changed. Okay, so the Old Covenant wasn't like God, like trashed. It was completed, and it was nailed to the cross. When it was nailed to the cross, and this is all according to, that term is actually used in Scripture. Okay, so that was nailed to the cross. We are no longer under the old Ten Commandments. But we are given a new set of commandments. We're under a new covenant now, and it does not have food, restrictions in it. You can eat all vegetables. You can eat all meat, even cloven hoof animals now. Now, the best example I was given between the Old Covenant and the New Covenant. Okay, so let's say some people leave, you know, Britain, and they take a ship forever, and they cross over to this new continent, and they form colonies, and then eventually they form their own laws, you know, and become their own country. We've heard about this happening in history, right? Yes, the old laws, you know, from that old government no longer apply to the new government. However, some of those laws are, you know, rewritten and reinforced, like murder's a thing that we're not going to allow. Okay, it's a good idea to bring that over. So there are some commandments in the New Testament that were actually brought over from the Old Testament because we still want that to be a thing. And that is just, that is, you know, that may not be the greatest comparison, but you know, that's the one that made my mind switch, you know, that helped me realize old covenant, new covenant. And so, you know, when it comes to food, you know, we could easily take this, you know, this first part of chapter 14 in Romans and make it all about our food arguments, right? Well, we're not supposed to have food arguments, basically, is what we're being told. One is not more moral than the other. One is, you know, if there are nutritional arguments, we're not going to go change somebody's mind. You know, at least I'm not. I am not going to go change somebody's mind. There are people much smarter with, you know, much more research, knowledge, and experience under their belt. Even though I've been, you know, basically pursuing and reading about this, you know, kind of eating, the low carb, you know, eating habits since, for over 20 years, maybe longer. But I don't consider myself an expert. You know, what I'm an expert on is how much I weigh. and I am starting to, after all these years of actually studying scripture, starting to get a better grasp of it. I thought I never would. I'm starting to get a better grasp of it. But scripture like this is not to be taken out of context for me to go bashing somebody who still is saying things like, you need to watch your calories, you're not getting everything you need from a meat-only diet, you know. And I want to say, well, you know, people smarter than me are saying otherwise, you know. But I, you know, I don't want to argue with these people. I, you know, I want to have loving friendships with these people. Way more important to me than to go beating someone over the head. So what I've done is, you know, I have said be careful of commentaries. You kind of got to be careful. Any commentary that, you know, brings that into our personal lives and makes it all completely about us, I'm wary of those. Because this isn't, these scriptures are here to help us understand Him. And they're not here to base some kind of, you know, the latest argument for the latest fad diet. You know, that's not what these are for. These are for understanding His will and how to walk in Christ. So, you know, I'm not going to go call someone weak who eats vegetables only. I got news for you. So, you know, my opinion is those people, some of them are pretty dang strong. And they've got some, you know, arguments because they've done research and they've listened to experts, you know, on their side of the fence when it comes to nutrition. But that is not what this is about. This is about Old Covenant versus New Covenant, about Jews and Gentiles, about, you know, following the old law or following the new law. And I encourage you, if you're going to do a devotional, it's basically, you know, what we've been told to do in scripture by the Lord is to study His word, not somebody else's version of it in some other book. I know there's some great ones out there, and for someone who's pretty strong in their knowledge, you know, some of those books can be great for personal study. I just don't think it's something, you know, to perpetuate to the masses when, you know, there is the greatest study book right here. And we can all understand it. And scripture even says, you know, God is not a God of confusion. We can understand it. And that anytime somebody starts speaking of scripture, always hold this book against what somebody else says. So go ahead, open the book, take a look, and, you know, come up with some real, you know, scripture-based knowledge. So, and again, this is meant to be encouraging. This is not meant to admonish anybody. I love, you know, my brothers and sisters in Christ. We disagree on certain points, but I still love them. And it's not my place to go beating them over the head. But I hope this encourages you to not look at this as a food argument. This is a clarification about where your heart is. I mean, if you're still under the old law, then your heart is under the old law and you have food restrictions. But if you're under the new law, you know, where the Gentiles were, the non-Jews were included, we're not under those food laws. But for those who actually cross over into the Christian era, you know, from the Old Testament to the New Testament, old covenant to new covenant, and you've crossed over and you realize that covenant was nailed to the cross, some, you know, we have new commandments now, and then yes, then you should realize you're under this, you know, non-food restricting covenant now. So it's all about where their heart is. If your heart is still in the old covenant, then don't go against that old covenant. If you've crossed over into the new covenant, you're free of any kind of restriction from the old covenant. So let's be good to each other. Be kind, you know. We can encourage each other, but we are not to, according to this, to his word, to condemn anybody. We're not to put moral values on foods. I think I've made that point. Yeah, it just keeps going through my head though. So I hope you guys have a great, great Sunday. Like I've said before, I got my, you know, I do my reading in the morning. I've got my communion cups up in the upper cabinet there so that I can on live stream. I usually watch the Oregon City Church of Christ go live at 10:30 Pacific, and it's the whole worship service. I like watching videos of Steve Higginbotham. I like Tim Ryan, even though he's not with, you know, one of our congregations anymore. I like the guy, and I struggle to find anything in scripture really that condemns what he's doing, because of my background with the Church of Christ. So I'm questioning it, but I want to stay open to make sure I'm not, you know, personally condemning someone for doing something a little different. You know, I love these guys. There's also Linda Road Church of Christ, who does things in a live stream. South Salem Church of Christ. Of course, you know, I'm Church of Christ, so those are the ones I'm looking at. But, you know, take a look at, you know, we're not adding to or taking away from Scripture. That's the point here. Just reading what it says and what its purpose is. So, anyway, I got to let you guys go. I got to go to work and get on with my reading, and I hope that you guys have a really great day. I love you guys. Bye.